In this video, we're going to look at entering a statistical entry. Go to Applications, General Ledger, going to enter the statistical journal entries. This is going to be set up the same way as journal entries as far as how you put in the data. You can either do it from the plus sign, do it from here, or do it within the journal itself. In this case, let's go into the actual journal we want to post to. In this case, it's going to be the payroll hours. Let's come here and click Add, and you'll see here is fairly similar to journal entries. You have your header that has posting date, description, reference number, comments that are internal, attachments, and you can also do automatic reversal dates. Transaction numbers are created automatically. Let me cancel out this so I can show you. These are the transaction numbers, and you can reference them in some custom reports. And it's easy just to track to see what you have. Additionally, as a side note, you can import statistical journal entries using their template, which is right here. Again, somewhat similar to the journal entries. You have your header information here, and then you have your line item entries over here. But you'll notice instead of debit credit, you have increase, decrease. And then you have your others also, as well as allocations, if you want to add an allocation to it. Now let's come back in here. And if you notice when I click add, we don't have the journal. We don't have to select a journal because we're already in a journal. So it's going to automatically post to that particular journal. We have a posting date, 7/26. I'm not going to worry about reversal in this case. It works the same way though. Test that. Creative, you can give a reference number. Let's just do it just for the giggles of it. Come here, you can choose a project or job. Let's do La Quinta, Austin. Let's do, where's my payroll? Don't know if I have a payroll Costco, and we may not do it when. So in this case, we're not going to worry about cost code or cost types. Of course, I may have it set where I have to. We'll find out momentarily. Let's do labor hours. Let's increase it by 40. I'm going to do an allocation. Now, I did come in here and use the edit entries layout to make it look like their journal entries layout, just because it's easier for data entry if they have a consistent look across multiple screens. Now, also remember, we're using 9000s. Preferably, you'd have alphanumerics or all alpha. Let's use our regular hour ones. Come down here, you can look to see any other information you want to add in. Since this is a statistical entry, your increase and decrease does not have to equal, so you don't have to have offsetting entries. And once you have it set, you can post a new, draft a new. Works the same way as it did in journal entries. Let's see if it'll let me post without my cost code and cost type. Yay, it did. So you can see our reference number shows up here. Now, as before, we can come over to our general ledger. You can choose a range. You can choose all accounts. You can choose a range of accounts. You can choose to include books in this report. In this particular case, I'm just trying to prove a point, so I'm going to choose the stat account I used, click View. I got to include, see, even I forget sometimes, include statistical accounts and output. Just because I can see it doesn't mean it's going to let me post it. So here, there we go, and we have our entry. Now, like I said, it's blue, so you can click on it and go down to the actual journal entry that you saw here. You can click on history, see the history created, posted. Now, you had the automatic reversal, but you can also reverse in the entry itself by clicking the reverse button here. Then the date, and it'll reverse it. I don't want to reverse it, though. It will keep a track of the history of when it was reversed. So you still have control over that as far as seeing who did it and when it was done. So let me show here. Come here, we can do edit or view. Have your posting date here. Description, comments. Cancel. Click view. And there's our reverse. You can also duplicate this entry. And this works for general journal entries as well, for all entries really. You can duplicate them, and what it does is it'll duplicate it with all the same values. You can come here and change the values that you might want to change. You want to be careful if you're duplicating that you're not reposting the exact same information, because it will let you do that in the statistical and general journal entries with the exact same information. So, but it's quick and easy. If say next month you need to post the same thing, you can duplicate it and post it. Of course, there's another function called recurring entries, which we'll look at in the next video, that'll do this automatically for you. Duplication works well though if you have pretty much everything's the same, but maybe you just need to like add a department on this entry. This works well if you have a big long entry and you only have to change a few items. You duplicate it and post it. It'll create it there. I'll still have the same reference number, which I probably should have changed. So let me edit it. In this case, I can edit it. Now, if you notice, and I'm sure people are going to freak out on this, but don't worry about it currently. You can still edit these entries as long as the period is open. When you close the period, these are no longer editable. Well, you can edit them, but when you try to save them, it's going to give you a big old... There is a way around that, which we will discuss in a little bit about journal approvals. But for now, that's our statistical entries.